Good afternoon, dear children.
How are you all?
Yes, you all are excellent and safe at home. Today we will see a new lesson from Beehive, that is Reach for the Dog. Reach, that is lesson number 8, Reach for the Dog. R-E-A-C-H, reaching for the top, you know, reaching for the top. Very, very, very inspiring story. You know, here in this lesson, Reach for the Top, two parts are there. And one part means this, both the parts are written about women. Both the women, very successful women. They have given, and when we see this story, you know, dear children, we get, you know, boost of energy, and we think that if they can do, why can't we? Yes, reach, how they have reached the top, that they have given in this lesson. The part one is about Santosh Yadav, belongs from Haryana, UP side. And other is for Western country, that is the part two they have given about Maria Sharapova, lawn tennis player. I think so. Maria Sharapova is a world famous. You know, I think so. You might have knew about her, but about, I think so, Santosh Yadav, you will listen first time. Just give attention, dear children, very interesting story. Many, many children, many people got inspired from them, and they are like them. So you can also. So we'll go to the first part, that is Santosh Yadav, first part. Today we will see the short summary of this lesson, and in the next lecture we will see about the detailed explanation on this lesson. Okay, so the Reach for the Top, part one, Santosh Yadav. What is the theme of the story? What is the theme of the story? What they want to tell in this lesson? So this chapter, Reach for the Top, is the story of two women who conquered, got victory, that conquered the world despite obstacles, and become the role model of youth, and become the role model of youth. See here, this sentence is conquered the world, not only the family, not only our locality, but the world, not only country, but world, despite obstacle. We see, dear children, many children or people say that, you know, I cannot study at home very properly because you have internet at home, I don't have that much internet at home, so I cannot study. You know, you have the nice PC and the mobiles and Android mobiles, so you can do all the things very clearly. So because of this, my parents did not give me, so I have not studied well, and because of that I got very less mark. No excuses, dear children. In our life, if you want to become a successful personality, there is no excuses. You have to fix your goal, particularly where I have to go. I think so, in the earlier chapters I have told many times that. Because see, why I am telling this chapter, both the chapters, part 1 and part 2, is telling about that only. Despite obstacles in their home, obstacles were there, permission was not there, financial problem was there, so still they have ignored all the things and they have reached the top. They have reached the top. So there is no excuses. No excuses, dear children. And we should not give the excuses also. If you want to get successful, and if you want to get successful, what one must be there? Which character must be there? Yes, we have learned in the childhood by APJ Abdul Kalam. From the beginning, determination, punctuation and hard work. These three things are there, if you are ready to do hard work in any situation, 101%, 1000%, that we get success. So here the two beautiful and the inspirational stories that we are going to be seeing. Okay, so we are going to be seeing the short summary about Santosh Yadav. We will see the Santosh Yadav birth and family background. We'll see upbringing of Santosh Yadav. Santosh Yadav in Jaipur and joins the Nehru Institute of Mountaineering, and Santosh as a human. Santosh Yadav, like Kiran, the girl, this name is in, we keep for the boys also and the girls also. The same thing here, the Santosh is not a boy, the Santosh Yadav, Santosh is a girl, woman. I've told here, the rich for the top, two women. This Santosh is also a woman. So the one and the very important thing be that the moral of the story, that what we can say, you are in the 9th standard, you must understand here in this standard most of the children, they keep the, you know, they fix their goal, what I want to become. So that for that we need, so in this both the chapter and now which I am explaining with that Santosh Yadav is the same. What is that? That is there, success come at cost. It never without a cost. It never without a cost. You have to pay it for in currency of you have to pay cost. Cost means what? What you have to pay? Money? No, dear children. You have to pay dedication. Cost means dedication. Dedication in each and all the work is very, very important. So, dedication is important. And hard work, focus and willpower. Willpower is very important. Will is very important. If you have that willpower, as that Abdul Kalam said, when he saw that at the age of 10, when he was in the 5th standard, that time his teacher was explaining that the birds were flying, so he said that when the birds can fly, why can't I? And he decided that I want to become like a bird, I want to fly, and accordingly he did. So dear children, you have to pay cost, and that cost is dedication, hard work and focus, and your willpower is very, very important for this. The same was with this Santosh, the same was with the, all these qualities she had. Okay, and Santosh, when she achieved success for herself, Santosh Yadav was born in Orthodox. You know, this girl was born and brought up, as I said, that Santosh Yadav birth and family. She got birth in Orthodox family. Orthodox family, Orthodox means Purane Khayalat ke log. You know, and the UP side, Haryana side, you know, that side. Then she was among the five siblings. She was the youngest daughter of them. And when her mother was expecting, that time one holy man had come to their house. Holy man, you know, sannyasi bolo ya jo ye bhavishya vagare jaise batate hai us jaise. So that holy man, the spiritual man, had visited in her house. Then he told that ki, okay, you will bless with a baby boy. And all of a sudden, you know, all of a sudden, her grandmother was there, and she said, no, we don't want any boy child now. Already we have 4. We want just give blessing to her that we want a baby girl. all was astonished because those Orthodox family and those area, they welcome only baby boy child, not girl child. And if any girl child born, take birth in their family, they feel very sad. But in that Orthodox family, when grandmother was there, she told that, no, don't give her that blessing. Just we want baby girl. And after few days, really, they got a beautiful girl, that her birth was there, that Santosh Yadav's birth was there. Okay. And born in an Orthodox society where the girl child was not welcome. From her early childhood, Santosh Yadav, from her early childhood, she showed the qualities of a rebel from the childhood. Understand? I will tell you later this day. Then from the child, okay, let me explain this first and then I will tell them. She went to study out of her village despite of her parents' unwillingness. She also enrolled herself. Her parents was not ready to send her in because, first of all, she is a female, girl child. And in the girl child in that village also, the unwillingness is, her parents were unwillingly, they were not willing to give them girl child a higher education. But she was focused, and you know, in those village, they always keep at the age of 15 and 16, those people, they get married, you know, that girls get married with at the age of 15 or 16 only. Okay, now, so here this Santosh Yadav birth, and as I said that she was taken birth in an Orthodox family. And what happened? Then upbringing of Santosh Yadav, how she brought up, she was born in a wealthy, and her family was wealthy, land owner's family. She began living her life her own term, means she was not, financially condition was very good, but only the Orthodox, as they were Orthodox, so they were not given freedom to girl child. Okay, she was just opposite to the other girls that in the village, as the other girls in the village, they used to wear the traditional dress and all, but she used to wear from the childhood shirts and pants. She was not liking the traditional dress customs. She was not allowed to go out of her village for education. The parents did not send her. They were not willing to send out of village. So she has taken the childhood education in the local areas only. And she sent to the local village to school. She decided to fight against the system. What the system was there? Not to take education and wear the traditional dresses and all. So she was opposing all the things. By birth, her nature was like that. Refused because she considered marriage the least important thing. Marriage, just now as I said that, okay, 15th or 16th, but she said that I will not get married. If she threatened her parents that if you will marry me, I will not marry only if you give me education, full education, then only I will be ready for marriage. So because of her determination and all, her parents were not forced her to get married. So they have to give her education. They have to give permission to take education. She threatened her family that she will never marry if she did not get a proper education. She came to Delhi for her education and then went to Jaipur for further studies. See, Haryana and Delhi nearby. She went to Delhi telling everyone that, no, I want to take study. From the beginning, that she had that, what is important, not like other girls that, no, if they are marrying, let me marry also, they are playing, let me. So her all the, the thinking, everything was different from other girls. And what is that? Then after that, she went to Delhi, and after that she went to Jaipur, capital of Rajasthan, to take further studies. Then she joined a renowned college named the Maharani College in Jaipur and got room. She got admission in Maharani College, and there, as she was alone, she has taken admission in the hostel, and the name of the hostel was Kasturba Hostel. So she was staying there, okay, and hostel, and just opposite to the range of Aravali, there the mountaineering range, Jaipur, the mountain range, mountain range, many ranges were there, and that which mountains were there near her hostel, opposite of her window, that if she sees out of window, she could see the mountain, not only mountain, one mountain, the mountain range. So that was Aravali mountain ranges were there, hills were there, Aravali hills, not mountain, the hills were there. From her hostel room, she used to see the villagers going up the hill and rapidly vanishing after a while. She saw that many people, she saw that they were climbing hills, and after few minutes and after few hours, when she saw, so they were disappearing. It was astonished for that, and she was eager, what is that, where they are disappearing? So she went to those people, and what happened? Hill and rapidly vanishing after a while, she decided to find out the truth herself. What is going on there? What they are doing? Where they are going? So one day she found all the details about it. And finally, she found out that they all were mountaineers, those who climb, the trekkings, the mount, they call the mountaineers. She asked them if she could join. She asked them, can I join there? So they said, agreed, and there was no looking back. And when they said, yes, you can also do. So she was so exciting, and she did not turn back to see. And without telling her parents, she has taken admission, because whenever we have to do anything, even though we are staying at hostel, we always take permission from our parents. She has taken admission, and then she informed her parents that I have taken admission, and then she apologized that, sorry mommy daddy, that I have not informed you, but I have taken admission. That when she was seeing that, it was forced that let me take this, and she has taken that. And after that, she has joined Jaipur. She went for the higher education, and after that she joins Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. There one institute is there, all the people, all the children, they go for the study of mountaineering. There they teach the mountaineering. Okay, Santosh enrolled herself in a course of Uttarkashi Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. She went there directly from Jaipur and later inform her parents. Before that, we are taking, she did not inform her parents about that. She wrote a letter to her father and apologized for taking admission in Uttarkashi. And her parents, as she was determined that whatever she want, focused, whatever willpower, the parents understood her, and they said okay. So they agree for that. Then starting the expedition. What? Santosh went on expedition. Expedition means, for the trekking and all, every year. Now their studies and their trekking, mountaineering started. She had an iron will and physical. This is very important. When you write if this question comes, all these qualities you must mention in the answer if it comes in the examination. That is what she had. She had an iron will and physical endurance to face any problem. Dear children, हम लोग एडवर्टाइज देखते हैं, कौन सी एडवर्टाइज है? ये ड्यूक की एडवर्टाइज है आई थिंक सो, अक्षय कुमार और जॉन अब्राहम्स एडवर्टाइज, जो डर गया सो मर गया. मीन्स डर कहाँ रहता है? डर इज इन आ माइंड. इफ यू आर फिक्स दैट देर इज नो एनीथिंग विल नॉट हैपन, इफ दैट डर इज नॉट देयर, स्केसिटी फियर यू नो इज नॉट देयर इन योर माइंड, यू कैन अचीव एनीथिंग. वो डर यदि अपने दिमाग में बैठ गया सो यू कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. Understand? So that she had a willpower mentally. She was very tough mentally. She was tough also. And in the year 1988, she joined the Aravalli Mountaineers. And in the year 1992, I think so. How many years? I think four years. How many? 88. 89, 1990, 1991, 4 years came the grand success. 4 years she worked hard. If you want to come in the merit list, if you want to come in the first in all over Maharashtra or all over India, idle sitting and not doing anything, or only 2 hours and 3 hours you are doing studies and expecting that I must come in the merit list, is this possible, dear children? I think so, no. You need much determination. You need much hard work. Day and night, as the Sachin Tendulkar also says, day and night I have practiced, and then he was, now you know the history. The rest history you know about Sachin Tendulkar. So in this 4 year, she did not turn back and beat the willpower. Iron, you know, what we can say that any problem, she was mentally iron. You know, iron mind, iron body. Physically, she was very tough. And the main thing, she told her mind that I have to do. So within this 4 year, means in the year 1992, came the grand success when she conquered the Mount Everest. See, she had come to take higher education, then she had come to the Jaipur. See, and this she saw out of a window and the mountaineering people, and they she inquired everything about that. She has taken admission, did the hard work with the determination, and got success, world success. See, the lesson is that despite conquered the world success. Not family success, not local success, not city success, not country success, but the world success within these 4 years. And came the grand success when she conquered the Mount Everest. She was barely 20 years old. 20 years old. अपने बच्चे क्या करते हैं? कॉलेज में जाके मजाक बनाते हैं. इसको छेड़ो, उसको छेड़ो, उसको टीज करो. दैट लाइफ इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट डोंट डू दैट, बट इफ यू आर फोकस सम गोल यू हैव टू फॉलो दैट. एट द एज ऑफ 20 शी गॉट द वर्ल्ड सक्सेस. Years of old, that time she became the youngest woman of the world to achieve this feat. She also became the member of an Indo-Nepalese woman's expedition and scaled the Everest the second time. One time reaching, many people are there. They tried many years to reach Mount Everest once only, but they couldn't. And this girl, Santosh Yadav, at the age of 21st time, and again she went the second time. This is a history in the world. Second times, you know, second time expedition, and scaled the Mount Everest second time in recognition of her achievements. As she has done the well deed for our country also, Indian government honored her with a very graced civilian award, that is a Padma Shri award she got. And not only she was Santosh, as a good human. She was a good human being. You know, what things we need while we are going to the trekking, mountain, the oxygens and all, how many, if you see the surf the net, you will come to know they are not alone, means that they have the heavy bags with them, then only they, and the situation is also odd. Which situation? Many situation, the cold and the rough situation, sometimes the what we can say, the hailing, you know, snowfall and all. In this situation they have to face. Okay, so she was a human, the best human being also. So during her expedition, during her trekking time, that she tried to save her fellow climbers. Not only alone they never go, they go in a group. So that time she saved one's life, that fellow trekker's life. How she climber's life? She shared her oxygen cylinder with her teammates. When they go together, that fellows, oxygen was not there with them, it was empty, I think so. So she shared her oxygen with her teammate. Although one of her teammates could not be saved, but another one could be saved because Santosh helped. I think so too. But she could save one teammate by giving her own oxygen to them or her. While returning from the Mount Everest, you know, dear children, when they go for the mountaineering, these mountaineering people only, they put garbages, you know, everywhere. But this Santosh Yadav, when she was coming from top to bottom, she averaged, she brought back 500 kgs of rubbish from there. The people, those who put, she collected all the things. See, many things are there already heavy in on their body. Again, this 500 kg also, she was like a best human being also. Rubbish from there, many mountaineers go for conquering. The ecology of the Everest, many conquering Everest here, they leave lots of garbage in their trail. Okay, so those garbage she had collected. Santosh act of upbringing back some garbage show her concern for the environment. She showed her concern that environment should not spoil. So collected and brought that 500 kg of rubbish from there when she was coming from top to bottom. She unfurled the Indian tricolor. It was a spiritual moment for her and she felt proud to be an Indian. She felt very proud to be an Indian, to keeping the top side Indian flag. How many people they go, different types of countries, the people, country, people from different countries, they come and they want to put their flag there. So she put our Indian flag top of the mountain. So she says that, okay, this is a very proud moment for me to be an Indian. हमारे घर में हम शादी एखादी छोटी सी चीज करते हैं तो मम्मी डैडी दादा दादी के नज़र में हमको कितना प्राउड लगता है. यस ना, यू मैट हैव एक्सपीरियंस दिस एक्सपीरियंस. यस ना, सो शी हैज डन फॉर द इंडियन. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ऑल्सो ऑनर्ड हर दैट बाय गिविंग अ ग्रेट सिविलाइजेशन सिविलियन अवार्ड, दैट इज अ पद्मश्री अवार्ड. And not only this, I'm talking about this too, just as listen there, this you have to give the cost. Giving cost, which cost? By money? No, dear children, cost of hard work, cost of determination, cost of punctuality, cost of willpower. If all these things are there with you, you also can achieve anything, whatever you have focused. And you know, dear children, everybody do something or other thing for us and for our family members, but do the unique thing for the world, means you will become a history history, understand? That is very difficult to do. But if they can do, why can't you? So here, as I said, that success come at cost. It is never without a cost. You have to pay for it in the currency of dedication, hard work, focus and willpower. The same was with Santosh when she achieved success for herself. Santosh Yadav was born in an orthodox family society where the girl child was not welcome. From her early childhood, she showed the qualities of a rebel. She went to study out of her village despite her parents' unwillingness. She also enrolled herself to pursue mountaineering, which required a lot of hard work. If we are telling after a few days, if the sports day is there, 15 days, if you will tell, your parents are telling, if your teachers are telling, okay, every day 1 hour you take a round and run, you feel very bored. Oh, baap re, mummy, utna bhagne ka, kya, ma'am, itna bhagne ka. How you will get, dear children? Don't say that. Impossible word is not in a dictionary. So like both of them. Santosh Yadav showed quality in her training like physical endurance, iron will, mental toughness and resistance to cold. It is very difficult to live in a cold and very extreme hot area. But she did in the extreme cold area. Okay, resistance to cold and altitude. These qualities help her to scale Mount Everest twice and get her name into the record books. She is an inspiration for all of us, but especially for girls. Especially for girls, all of us, but especially for us. I know, dear children, in the 9th standard, many talented children are there in my classes. So I am expecting unique thing from you, not this in social, in science, in art, in any many things are there. You know, if you see in the world, many things are there. Wherever you want to go, make a history of that. I'm expecting from you because my children, 9th standard children, are very extraordinary. Yes, okay, one can learn the values of being mentally tough, determined, dedicated and helping others. Be a best human being. So help always others. When you are helping others, God is always there to help us without selfishness. Understand? Don't expect anything from others, but just give. So God is there to give everything. Okay, helpless others from her. Her life shows us that nothing is impossible if one is passionate and determined about one's goal. This is the part one of this lesson, that is reach for the top. Santosh Yadav. I think so, dear children, you like this story. So read this story before I explain in detail, before my detailed explanation, you will understand the whole story of this. Thank you and have a nice day.